Hello class, let us begin the story Girls by Mrinal Pandey. As I told you in the last video, the broad setting of this story is this, that is patriarchy. Okay. The story is told in the first person narration, and the narrator is also a character in this story. She is the middle daughter of this family that we are going to talk about. I read the first stanza, which is the exposition as far as the plot of the story is concerned. The day we left with Ma for Nani's house, Babu broke a sirai. Sirai is the earthen pot for water, and Babu is the father in this family. So the day we left, now this we is for the girls, and they are going to their nani's house with their ma, with their mother, and the father breaks a sirai. I don't know whether he did it on purpose or by accident, and the narrator says, I don't know whether the father has done that by any chance, accident, or deliberately, by on purpose. But anyway, the floor was flooded with water. So there is water split on the floor. Ma held up her sari and called Saru's mother. So this is the maid in the family, woman servant in the family, who is called as Saru's mother. So she is ordered by the mother to clear that. Who was trying to evas drop from the adjacent room. Evas drop is trying to spy on or trying to know something, know about what people are talking or doing by hiding at a place. Who was trying to evas drop from the adjacent room, from the room by the side, to mop up. So she comes there to mop, to clean the floor. Someone where to sleep and break the bones, it would be yet another problem. Because the narrator says, in case someone falls because of someone slips on that water and breaks any bone, then there is another problem. Now, first, we should understand that this story is told from a child's perspective, from a child's point of view. Now, this point of view or this perspective is known as the naive point of view. Means naive is a person who is innocent and who does not know many things. Okay. So this is the child's point of view, because the narrator is a girl of 8 years old. Everything in life was a problem. She says to my mother, everything in life was a problem. So this is how the character of the mother is developed. The child says, the narrator says about her mother that to Ma everything in life was a problem. So this is the character of a woman who has a lot of problems in her life. Okay. And even her child can understand that. As far as she was concerned, whether we were at home or at school, ill or just playing around, we were a problem. So she gives examples, she gives evidences. She says our mother has a lot of problems. She says even if we are ill or at school or playing or we might be doing anything and that is a problem to our mother. While mopping the floor, Saru's mother looked up at Ma and asked, "This time you will be away for at least 3 months." Saru's mother looks at the mother and narrator's mother and she asks, "This time you will be away for 3 months." Ma squatted down and said, so she sits down and says, "Yes, they won't allow me to come back sooner." They means her maternal people, her people at her mother's house. "She turned to me and ordered me to go out and play. I always seem to turn up at the wrong time and at the wrong place." Now this is something about the narrators. She says, it so happens that I always be present at the wrong places and at the wrong time, so that people tell me to go away before talking something important. "As I was leaving the room, I managed to pick up a piece of the broken zurai and which I enjoyed sucking." So she enjoys. Now this is a common feature of children. They always like to suck something that is made up of earth, that is made up of mud. So she says, I enjoyed the broken piece of surai sucking and I overheard Ma addressing either Saru's mother or the cobwebs, the hanging cobwebs, kolyanche jaal, hanging from the roof. "I hope it's a boy this time." And by the end of the first paragraph of this short story, we get to know the conflict of the story through the mother's dialogue. And the mother says that, "I hope it's a boy this time." Now this is the problem of this short story. Because here is a family having three girls, three daughters and no boy, no son. And the mother is expecting for the fourth time. That's why she is going to her mother's place for the delivery. And there she will be spending at least 3 months, that we come to know from Saru's mother's dialogue. And the mother, by the end of narrator's mother, by the end of this first paragraph, she says, and that is the problem of this short story, that is the conflict in this short story, and she says, "I hope it's a boy this time. It will relieve me of the nuisance of going through another pregnancy." Now this is the fate of many Indian women even in the 21st century. Though the story was written in the decades of the 80s of the last century, in 1983 84 something, still it's the problem of many Indian women, because they have to deliver children until they get a boy, they get a son, or either they get the abortions of the female fetus, or they go on delivering children till they get a boy. "I hope it's a boy this time." And the next sentence is very important. She says, "It will relieve me of the nuisance of going through another pregnancy." So she says, "I will be, once I get a boy, once I get a son delivered, I will be free of this problem, this nuisance, cut, this irritating thing of going through another pregnancy." So too many pregnancies are nuisance, they are problems. problematic for a woman. But patriarchy, as I told you, the broad context or the setting of this short story is the patriarchy in the Indian society. And within the patriarchy, what is a woman? A woman is equal to a womb. A woman is equal to a uterus. Okay. So a woman is a reproductive machine, and she should deliver a male child. Unless and until she gives birth to a son, her life cannot be complete. That is what the tradition says, and that is what the tradition expects from a woman. And here is a woman, she had delivered three times, and she had delivered all the three girls, and her family wants a son, and that's why she is again pregnant for the fourth time. And she says she is not interested either in a girl or a boy. She is only interested that there should be a boy so that I'll get rid of all these pregnancies, so that I will not have to undergo all the pregnancies again and again. So this is a very bitter comment upon the pathetic situation of women in the Indian society. I could just imagine Saru's mother, the narrator says, I could just imagine Saru's mother in her usual manner shaking her head and saying, why not? Why not? And Saru's mother, when the mother says, I hope it's a boy this time, Saru's mother says, why not? Why not? So she says, let us hope. So this is the introduction. This is the exposition that talks about the crisis or conflict in the story, and which is having a male child. So far, here is a woman who had given birth to three daughters, and this time she wants a boy so that she will be free of the too many pregnancies that she has to undergo. We'll continue tomorrow. Thank you.